Welcome. What are we learning today? Today we're learning how to dance. No, we're not learning that kind of dance. We're going to learn how to dance with the test light. What does that mean, to dance with the test light? That means to know all the steps and the moves and look good while you're doing it. How many steps are they? 10. I do 10 things with this test light. So many people limit themselves. I don't want you to be like that. I want you to dance with the test light. Are you ready to count? I use a test light to check for positive. I use a test light to check for negative. I use a test light to check for positive and negative at the same time. I call it loop. While we're looping, we might as well use it as an injectornoid light. I ain't kidding. This test light can check for parasitic drain. We're halfway there. The test light can be used to test almost any part of the circuit to see if it is open, complete, or shorted. I'm not kidding. In the right hands, what else can I do with this electrically? I can use it to get Ford OBD1 codes. They blink and you get the code and you go on with it. And what's the last thing I do with it? I can use this plain 12-volt test light to perform an engine cylinder balance analyzer. But before we go to our most favorite place, the hood, as like under the hood, let's get ready to go to the hood. First things first, a little safety protection. Whatever it takes to encourage you to get on that battery electrical circuit, whatever it takes, yes, let's do it. Before we go to the hood, come on down. Let me show you what we need to make. Oh, you could buy them, but it's just more satisfying. We're gonna need an appliance cord, an extension cord, just typical average cord. We're gonna need that. We're going to need some wire cutters and strippers. They're going to be very helpful in making and repairing electrical tools. We're going to need a couple of small alligator clips. This one is way too big. We just need a couple of those, a pair of scissors, and a pair of pliers. Here's what we're going to do. We're going to take what used to be almost trash, and we're going to make a couple of electrical tools. In order to learn the first step, you need to be able to come in here and make your electrical tools. Okay, we start by splitting, and we're going to use a lot of this, so let's get that out of the way. Let's go ahead and split the whole thing so we're ready to go. Wire cutters, very handy at this time. We cut the wires. I'll go ahead and start concentrating on one of them. Here's what we're going to do. We're going to make our first tool, the easy one first. It takes a little practice, but you can get the hang of it. You're going to strip a section of that wire, okay? You're going to strip almost an inch. No, not half. You need at least 3/4 of an inch. Now you're going to need about 8 to 10 inches, and then you're going to cut. We've almost got our first tool out of the way. That's the easy one. I'm not kidding. This is a very useful tool. We're going to come in here, and what have I done? I have taken an old extension cord, and I've cut it, and I've stripped it. But I want to take a moment. I want to take a moment for you to understand exactly what this piece of wire is. This piece of wire is way more than just a piece of wire. In the right hands, you're going to use this piece of wire to test relays, switches, circuits, modules. Yes, it's hard to believe, but let's go on. We're halfway there. Now we only need one more thing. Back to our workstation. Right over here, we're going to start off almost doing the same thing. We've got our old extension, but this time we're going to want to strip as much as possible, over an inch and maybe even 2 inches. Now this stripper's working well, and I'm pretty sure you can see that looks like way more than what we need, but we're almost there. Okay, this is what we've done so far. we've stripped almost 2 inches. Why do we need so much? Well, you'll see. We're going to start learning how to work with wire. How to use the wire, connect the wire, test the wire. I fold it over. I squeeze down, and one more. I want a lot of copper. I want a lot of material that's going to take up this space in the alligator. I prepare this jumper wire to receive the alligator. You don't need to solder or crimp. Well, yes, we're going to crimp somewhat, but the most important thing is that you fill up this space in the alligator clip with as much copper as possible. We want our tool to last. So once we've stripped and folded and twisted and folded, I come in here and I pay attention, and it's almost always at the top, the seam, the crease, where it folds together. We're just going to take a regular pair of pliers, and we're going to try to force that center down. We're going to come in here, and we're going to give it a bit of a squeeze. We're not done yet. Now, it looks like I was fairly successful in making the seam go down. We're getting closer. Now, I'm going to come in the side, and I'm going to squeeze some more. It's not rocket science. Okay, it should be able to withstand a tug. I'm going to give it one more squeeze because I want it to last. There, that should do it. We're almost done. We're going to use these here in just a little bit with our test slide. Now, we're going to go ahead and do the same thing on the other side, and we're going to take you to the hood. Are we ready to go? All right. We're ready. We have three things. We have the most simple of all test lights, the most inexpensive ones. These inexpensive test lights do more things than those power logic modules, and they're just as good and just as reliable. Let's go to the hood, and we're going to learn our first most common necessary step. We're going to learn to check for positive in several places. Come on. Okay, folks, here we go. Finally, to the hood. Now, our first video showed you that you're not going to get electrocuted. These gloves are going to help you, to encourage you, right? We're going to be careful when it's time to jump, but let's put our test light to work. Okay, there's three parts to the test light. Okay, there's the alligator clip. Right? And then there's the pointy part called the probe, the light and the wire. Okay, where does the alligator clip go? 10 answers. Depends what we're doing. But for our first step, let's get right to it. I hope you can see it. I know if I turn on my particular vehicle or this particular battery, because it's very easy to see it. All right, we're going to learn our first step. And if you keep coming around, I promise you 9 more. And those are all electrical tests. First things first, test the tester, right? We're going to put the alligator clip on the negative. Okay, anytime you connect this is important. Anytime, we're not afraid to get electrocuted, especially with the gloves now. Okay, when you connect the alligator clip, I say dig in. Dig in means to make contact. All right, over here, we're testing the tester. We're ready to go. This is our first most basic step in testing for positive. Now, one of the most common places to test for positive is going to be over at this electrical box. This electrical box is got different names, but we'll just call it the electrical box. And in the electrical box, we're going to have fuses, and we're going to have relays. And yes, we're going to have to use this. We know our light's ready to go. Okay, I'm just going to give you some super basics about the fuses. There's 3 categories. Okay, let's see if we can find the first category. Category number 1, hot all the time. Okay, what I've done, the fuse has, well, might as well show you a mechanical purpose for this test light. This test light, this is not one of the steps. I use the test light to remove it. Do not remove the fuse to test it. The reason is because you want to test not just the fuse, you want to test the circuit and the wires and the connections that go to the fuse. Right? There's two special places for you to test the fuse on this particular type. And I highly recommend you not take it out. If you can see, I'm pretty sure I'll get to focus in for you. I'm going to put the fuse back. There's three major categories to hot. This one is called hot all the time. To test the fuse, you check it on both sides. If one side lights up and the other side does not light up, the fuse is bad. Let's try to find category number two. Category number two is, it's probably a key on hot. A key on hot is where you have to turn the key on to get some hot. Now the boxes can have some information for you, and I'm going to go ahead and use the information that I can see here. And that particular one says for the heater. That means I probably have to turn the heater on in order for that for that fuse to work. Now, I don't want to take too long to get to some more challenging fuses. There are several types of fuses. These ones are easy. You test them in place. These fuses right here, you test them a little bit different. Now, the idea is you're supposed to look at it. You're supposed to look into the plastic, and you're supposed to be able to see that little bridge that connects the both sides together. Now, you still have to take this out to test it correctly, and that's why we needed the jumper and the little wire. Do not take a pair of pliers, right? These, like this one, I'll work it back and forth, but here, this tool can be used to help you remove what I call a cartridge type fuse. No, don't take the cover off. No, don't use a pair of pliers. I think this was just about out. And I'm going to show you why we need a jumper wire and an adapter to go along with that. Earlier, we made some jumper wires. We made one, and you almost always need two. So here is our tool here. Now, we have to be careful here. Okay, I'm not going to ignore it. This battery could explode. Your battery could explode. Are we done? Forget it. Give it up. It's very unlikely that the battery explodes. Two things have to happen, and we're going to avoid both of them. The first thing that's going to have to happen is sparks. Any kind of sparks around the battery, and you're almost halfway there. Batteries are so much safer than they used to be. They don't gas as much. But you're going to be careful. You're going to be careful because in order to test this one, let me show you how you're going to do it. You're going to make that one jumper wire that you made. You're going to use that one, what we'll start calling adapter. We'll use this as an adapter. We twist it up a little bit here. We're going to stick this in there. We're going to stick this guy right in there. The fit, just basic fit right here. Okay. We always have to be aware of our polarities. Are we testing this one? Are we testing that one? What are we testing? The way to test this particular fuse is, yes, here we go. We're about to get some positive, and we have to be careful with it. Anytime you're using alligator clips, it's the same thing. You dig in. You dig in. Now, I'm gonna. So far, I'm not sparking. I know what I'm doing, and there's no sparks yet. But I'm going to go ahead and set a good example by moving away from the top of the battery. I don't expect any sparks at this time either. Now, let me show you what we've done so far. You have to be aware of the loose ends. This guy has positive. If I was careless and I let it to touch anything metal, it would spark. And then we'd get nervous, and we don't want that. We're going to use our test light. We test our tester, and let's see if you can see what I'm doing here. I'm going to come in like this. It's not rocket science. This is how you physically test this particular type of fuse. Okay? Yes, you have to take it out. And we're gonna have another lesson on fuses, because we have to understand what the fuses do. Now, we're being careful. If I touch, you believe me? You believe me? If I touch this, there's a spark. I know what I'm doing, and I'm being careful. So once I do this, now I don't have to pay too much attention to it. So we're going to put this fuse back because I just wanted to show you what it's like to test the fuse. Now, we're almost done. Thank you for sticking around. Right here, we're going to use the test light to check for positive and then negative, and then we're going to loop it, and then we're going to do pulse, and then we're going to do parasitic. Keep coming back, folks. I've got plenty of electrical for you. I hope you learn something. I hope you keep coming back. And you know what I really like most of all? I like those thumbs up. At least, folks, if you give me a thumb up, I'll be happy. Until next time, thank you. Okay, folks, that was lesson number 3 on automotive electrical. If you missed the first two, the first one has the title, "He Likes Getting Electrocuted." It proves to you, it shows you that the battery voltage is not going to electrocute you, but it gives you heads up on getting burned. We're almost to the testing where we have to be careful about how we jump it. The second video, I do several things, very important. These lessons go in a sequence. I showed you 3 things in the second video. The second video, magnets are magic. And I hope you remember, if you haven't seen it, it shows you the power of electromagnetism. It shows you and explains an open circuit. It shows you and explains a shorted circuit. Okay, so we're just scratching the surface. I wanted to cover so much more. This seems like a very good subject area. I put out over 20 videos on air conditioning. I bet you I can put out 20 videos on electrical. I hope you keep coming back. Thank you.